concrete canyons of Harlem, New York, stands a basketball court where the legends of the game are born. Rucker Park. Between the lines of this battleground, a great many tales of warriors have come and gone. But there was one player whose talents soared far above the rest. His name, Uncle Drew.
So good.
Incredible.
Like, scary good.
Dominating.
Dangerous.
Best of the best.
Bananas.
I mean, you know, he just brought things to the game that the game had never seen before. Changed the face of basketball.
Drew been dangerous since birth.
My pops played him one-on-one in the seventh grade. He broke my pops' ankle. True story. Gym teacher gave him a D.
Can they show you one trick to beat you with another trick?
Shaking people's sneakers off. They falling out the trees.
He was a bad man.
He went to one end of the court, shot the lights out, went to the other end of the court, shot it back on again.
And he was good enough to be the logo.
Wait, I thought you were the NBA logo.
It's actually Uncle Drew. They just shaved his afro off.
One time he took on the Destroyer and beat him only with his left hand. And then hold on, wait for it. With his right hand, he was eating a ham sandwich.
Was there anyone out there better than Uncle Drew?
With word of Sandwichgate and Black Ankle Sunday both spreading like wildfire, Uncle Drew and his childhood friends shot to the top of the first Rucker Classic in 68. But it was not long before it all came crashing down.
It had to be something concerning him and the female. We knew that.
Uncle Drew and the ladies? Yeah.
Man, the rumor was, man, Drew slept with one of his teammates' girl the night before the finals.
That when it came time to play in the finals, they were all a complete and total no-show.
And after that, he just disappeared.
Despite the mysterious disappearance of its greatest player, the fabled park is still the epicenter of the streetball universe. The question is, will this year's Rucker Classic see the birth of a new playground legend? I might pull up with one, maybe two.